Hi all, today we are discussing about cash book. Simple cash book we are discussing. Cash book includes all the cash transactions, whether cash received or paid, all kind of cash and cash transactions will be included in the cash book. First let's see what is the format of cash book. This is simple cash book. Format, first you have date, on which date transaction happened, particulars, receipt number, what is the number of receipt and what is the ledger folio, and then amount. The same thing for the credit side also. Left hand side is called debit and right hand side is called credit. Now to make it simple, you can write down left hand side or debit side or receipts will be taken, and credit side all payments will be taken. Through the journal entry you can write down this one, or else read the transaction, is the receipt to you or payment to you. Check it out and you can write down. Both the ways you can solve this question. Now let us take down one question with the small transactions. Here, first transaction commenced business with cash on 2004, January 1st. 2004, January 1st. Commenced business with cash. So it is receipt to the business. That means some money is coming inside the business. So it is receipt to the business. So you can start up with two capital account. Two capital account, 2400. Started business with cash with the amount of 2400. With journal entry, if you want to write down cash account debtor to capital account. So cash debit side you have. So you are writing debit side to capital account. Got it? Number one, it is a receipt to you. So you can write down debit side. Or else through the journal entry, cash to capital, so you are writing to capital account. The next transaction, cash purchases. It is cash purchases. When you purchase something, you are paying cash. So cash is going outside. When it is going outside, it will be treated as payment. When cash is going outside, we will be treated it as payment. So by purchases. By purchases account, and the amount is 2000. Date January 2nd. Through the journal, if you want to write down purchases account data to cash account. So cash you can see credit side. So writing in the credit side by purchases. What is the next transaction? Cash sales. Cash sales means cash is coming inside. You sold the goods, so you are receiving the money. So write down debit side to sales on 6th to sales account. What is the amount? The amount is 4000 rupees. Cash sales, when you sold goods, you are receiving the cash. So it is received to you. So you will be writing debit side to sales. Through the journal entry, if you want to write down, the journal will be cash account debtor to sales account. Cash is debit side, so you are writing debit side to sales account, amount 4000. What is the next transaction? Received commission 200. On 15th, received commission 200. When you received money, it is a receipt to you. Debit side to commission account 200. Through journal, if you want to write, cash account debtor to commission account. Cash account debtor to commission account. Debit side you can see cash. So write down debit side to commission account 200. Or else commission is received to you. Write down receipt side to commission account. What is the next transaction? Paid interest. You paid the interest. So it is a payment to you by interest account. By interest account, what is the amount? Amount is 160 on the date of 18th. It happened on 18th. Interest paid, it is payment to you, so you have written payment side. Through the journal, if you want to write the interest account debtor to cash account, cash is credit side, so credit side you are writing by interest. What is the next transaction? The next transaction is paid for stationery. This is also payment to you by stationery account. By stationery account, the amount is 240 on 28th. Next, on 29th, received from Ram. You have received some money from Ram. Received mentioned in the question itself, and receipt will be coming debit side to Ram account. RAM account, what is the amount? The amount is 2000 rupees. If you go through the journal received from RAM, the journal will be cash account data to RAM account. Cash is debit side, so debit side you are writing to RAM account. What is the next transaction? The next transaction is paid to Anand. You have paid some money to Anand. It is payment to you by Anand account on 30th. The amount is 1000. It is a payment, so you have written credit side. The next one, withdrawn for personal use. Withdrawn for personal use from the business, some money you have withdrawn for your personal use. It is a payment to the business or loss to the business by drawings account. By drawings account, and the amount is 600. Now, whenever you see the ledger or account, the account means debit and credit both should be equal. If it is not equal, you should make it equal. So first let us see which side you have more, debit side or credit side. Debit side you have more, that is 8600. 8600. So credit side how much you have? After subtracting everything, you will get the balance amount of 4600. Cross it, 4000. 4000 is the total. You are total, you require total 8600. How much is less? 4600 is less. This will be called as by balance carry down on 31st. By the month end, your total receipts are 8600. Your total payments are 4000. Now you are having in your hand 4600 cash with you to start for the next month. On the next month, on Feb 1st, two balance brought down 4600. Hope all of you understood. Once again, debit all the receipts, credit all the payments. If you have any doubt, please keep posted. Thank you.